from now the great state of Alabama. Man, it was a nail biter. It was so close. Roy Moore was leading throughout, which, by the way, doesn't mean anything. It's just a matter of what order they count the votes. So it's just a matter of the counting. He wasn't actually leading. It's razor thin at the end. 99% reporting. Doug Jones has, in fact, won. Everyone has called election for Doug Jones. Roy Moore has lost, but it was only by 0.7 points, 0.7. And they just counted the areas that went to Doug Jones last, so that's why it appeared that he pulled ahead at the end. It was less than 10,000 votes that decided it. About 641,000 to 631,000 with 99% reporting. So it, as close as it gets, over 1.2 million votes and decided by about 9,000 votes overall. So what's my thoughts about it? Well, as it just happened now, first of all, to the Republicans in the Senate, brace for impact. No, I'm kidding around. That's a reference to the 2016 election night. No, look, I'm not overjoyed in terms of, for example, are they going to be able to get the tax cuts? My guess is they're Republicans. They'll get the tax cuts. They'll all vote for it. That's what their donors want. They still have 51 votes. You know, you never know with Donald Trump. He could screw up anything. But they'd still have to work pretty hard to screw that up. And other than the tax cuts, I don't think they were going to get anything anyway. So I don't think that it has a big legislative difference. And I know that right wing has these theories about how the liberals want to control your life and they want to control this and that. Nah, man. Look, of course we want to win, and we want to win on most importantly policy priorities. Doug Jones is not a huge progressive, but way, way better, a million times better than Roy Moore. So it's not a matter of huge celebration over policy differences here, because we likely won't have that many policy differences in terms of whether you have 51 or 52 Republicans in the Senate. But if they defeated the horrendous tax cuts for the rich, that would be wonderful if that was a result of this. But like I said, I doubt it. We'll have to see how it plays out. So the thing that I actually feel is just relief. Relief that we're not quite as much of monsters as we could have been. Right? And I know it's almost a tie. So, I mean, there it was, like a battle of almost literally, in this case, good versus evil. And that about defines humanity, right? Well, we're about 50% good and 50% evil, or maybe just a tiny half a percent more good than evil. Man, it really is a metaphor in a lot of ways for our nature as humans. And, you know, it's just a kind of a funny thing to say, but I feel a little bit of relief for Alabama and even Alabama Republicans. I didn't want you to be that bad of guys. I didn't want you to put Roy Moore in the Senate, and then you got to live with that the rest of your life. You got to live that with that the rest of our political lives overall. And so I'm glad Doug Jones won. I'm glad decency won. I'm glad that we don't have to now worry about what we're going to do with a child predator in the Senate. And that as a country, we're not that bad. By 0.7%, we're not that bad. So, thanks God for that. And yes, for later elections that are not held in deeply red states like Alabama, it is a sign of great things to come, I believe, for progressives, especially when we get real progressives. And not a very good sign for Republicans overall. But to be fair to Republicans, this was a particularly terrible, terrible candidate. So I think if you're a Republican and you didn't agree with Roy Moore, whether it's on race or religion or the Constitution or being a child predator, it's a good day for you, because now you're not going to have to worry about him representing the Republican brand. So I would argue in a lot of ways it's a win for all of us. And just one big sigh of relief. All right. Oh, wait, I finally get to say it. Down goes Roy Moore. Down goes Roy Moore. Thank God, down goes Roy Moore.